Hello friends, this time we are doing a periodic service on a Golf 7 or MK7 equipped with a 1.6 liter diesel engine producing 110 horsepower. It's a very simple task, perfect for beginners if you follow all the steps shown. In this episode we will replace the diesel fuel filter without using software for priming the system for those who don't have diagnostic software. For those who have VCDS and don't know how to do it yet, I will add a video in the description with all the steps. Let's not waste any more time and get to work. First, unclip the engine cover and set it aside so you can have more space. Next, you'll have to remove the splash shield to access the oil drain plug and the oil filter housing. To remove the drain plug, you'll need a 17mm wrench. Place a container under the oil pan and remove the plug. Ideally, the engine should be a bit warm, so wear protective gloves. Let the oil drain and move on to changing the air filter. The air filter housing cover is secured with about 70-30 screws. Before inserting the new air filter, it's important to vacuum out any dirt inside the housing. Tighten the screws by hand as the plastic is quite fragile. Next, we will replace the diesel fuel filter. Place a cloth or several tissues around the filter housing to absorb any fuel spills. You'll need a container and a T25 bit to remove the 5 screws. Use a small flathead screwdriver to carefully lift the filter housing cover. Use something to keep the cover open, we usually use a thin metal wire. Slowly lift out the oil filter, let the diesel drain out of it and place it in a container. We usually replace the diesel filters annually or every 10,000 kilometers, so there's no buildup in the filter housing. If you are replacing it after a long interval, inspect the bottom of the housing and if there is any dirt, drain all the diesel, clean the inside and refill with clean diesel as shown in previous tutorials. Insert the new diesel filter and let it sink on its own. Add clean diesel until it reaches the level shown in the video. Clean the edges of the housing and place the cap back on. Tighten the screws in a criss-cross pattern by hand. If you have a torque wrench, the tightening torque is 5 Nm. And we're done with the fuel filter. You'll find the cabin filter behind the glove box. To remove it, press two clips, one on the right and one on the left. For the pollen filter housing cover, you'll need to press 3 clips using a screwdriver as shown. When inserting the new filter, make sure the arrow indicating the airflow direction is pointing downward. Now we only have to change the oil filter. Unfortunately, Volkswagen, as with Skoda Superb, has positioned the oil filter housing in a not so accessible location, right over here. The filter cover has a 13mm plug, but even if you drain the oil from there, you'll still have leaks and you'll have to remove the cover with the filter anyway. We will remove the whole cover using a 32mm socket. Place the oil container under the cover and remove it. If you found a clean and easy method for changing the oil filter, please let us know in the comments. This is what the oil filter housing looks like after you remove the cover and filter. You'll need to replace the large O-ring around the cover and the small one around the central plug, because over time it can fail and you might get oil leaks. Clean the cover with brake cleaner spray and a cloth or tissues. Insert the new oil filter. You'll hear a characteristic click when it snaps into place. Now we can screw the cover back over the filter. The tightening torque for the cover is 25 Nm and for the plug is 5 Nm. Clean all the oil spills and you're done with the oil filter. Reinsert the oil sump plug and tighten it to a torque of 30 Nm. For this engine, the oil capacity is 4.7 liters. We recommend initially adding 4.5 liters and then adjusting based on the dipstick reading. It should always be between the minimum and the maximum levels. Now you can thread the oil filler cap and start the engine. Don't forget to replace the engine cover and most importantly, give this tutorial a like and subscribe to the channel. Goodbye!